Part 6 of A Christmas Shiz. I'm gonna get right into it. This is the last video. The coroner's office had called later that evening. My mother had died of a brain aneurysm. The voice on the line explained that my mother had gone very quickly and gone to bed. I called Hugh and made a number of other calls to relatives and friends. Bobby. Come here. You want to be picked up. Before kissing him, I said Lily goodnight, holding him tightly in my arms. Katie and I sat together in the living room, lit only by a tiny white light of the kid Christmas tree. Say hi. Yeah, good job. Now, you play. Huh?
I'm gonna...
Bobby. Sit. White lights is good. I was thinking we should bury her in the pyramid corner. Staring into the light. And my new blouse and pin. My voice falls in my throat. And she would definitely want a pin because it has the stones of all her grandchildren in it. I laugh, wiping the tears from my face. She never let me hear the end of it. I didn't bury her with the pin that represents all her grandbabies.
What?
In the back of the sofa, wiping the tears with both hands from her face. I'm going to ask Dalton to say something at the funeral, I said. I can't imagine anyone else doing it. I can't either, Kate reassured. I glanced at my watch. Hugh's flight is at 10. They're all there tomorrow morning. We can plan for the rest of the service with the pastor when he gets here. I went to on the sofa and buried my face in my hands, rubbing the tired, bloodshot eyes with the heels of my hands. Kate scooted over, grabbed my hand, and set it on her lap, holding on to it as she fell asleep. I gently drew the throat over Kate and sat quietly in the stillness, staring at the sister. The way my mother had always loved. To do. I recalled that the day Hannah and Lily had decorated the tree, small hands digging through the box of the decoration. Child clamoring to find the next present. The tree was more than just a decoration. It was a daily reminder. I wiped another tear. What a lousy time of year to lose your mother, I said, rubbing my temples. When my head started to bob, I felt myself nodding off in the early morning hours. I stood to retrieve the blanket from the closet for myself. I found myself nodding off to early morning hours. I stood to retrieve the closet for myself. I straightened Kate's leg on the sofa and started to empty my pockets when I felt the Dalton earlier amid all of the commotion. I had forgotten about all of that. I turned the lantern towards the light. began to read. I know this is the hard part. But one day you'll understand. That is worth it. I wept as I read the unfinished letter. Say bye, say bye. And that is it. And have a great day. Bye.